I was a little surprised that he picked her. I've been watching her for a long time, and she did very, very poorly in the primaries, as you know. She was very, very nasty. She was very disrespectful to Joe Biden. And I thought she was the meanest, the most horrible, most disrespectful of anybody in the U.S. Senate.
美国2020总统大选在拜登公布副手搭档尘埃落定后，随即进入丑陋新篇章。川普与一众盟友从共和党到福斯新闻联手合推攻击剧本，直指贺锦丽能从众多女性候选名单脱颖而出，是所属民主党一盘机关算尽的大选棋局。
And I'll tell you that there were majority of women.In the electorate last time, and yet they voted for Donald Trump over Hillary Clinton. He became the president. So I think this notion that men and women vote for men and women, and genders had a slight preference for their own gender, but the number one overwhelming answer was it depends on other things. So I think in the case of Kamala Harris, it'll be very easy to say somebody who seems to, who presents as progressive and quote forward-looking could actually bring our nation backward on many things that matter to America.
This pick now solidifies what is the most extreme radical, far left, out of the mainstream ticket of any major political party in American history.
川普抛出的阴谋论是民主党看似预借贺锦丽一箭双雕，协助填补拜登老白男形象缺口，开发亚非裔族群票源，也拉抬女性选票。实则着眼四年后由一战成名的贺锦丽征战总统大会，盼他靠非裔身份写下类奥巴马传奇，直言拜登虽是民主党共主，是该党认为能争取票源最大公约数的温和中间派，但垂垂老矣，不可能争取连任，只是过渡人选。贺锦丽才是民主党盘算未来4到8年的新共主。警告全美选民，应该思考是否让贺锦丽这位早在初选时就露出马脚、福音激进左派的假主流派入主白宫，进而打开这股暗黑政治势力未来大举接掌美国的可能性呢？
Kamala Harris ran for president by rushing to the radical left, embracing Bernie's plan for socialized medicine, calling for trillions in new taxes, attacking Joe Biden for racist policies. Voters rejected Harris. They smartly spotted a phony. But not Joe Biden. He's not that smart. Biden calls himself a transition candidate. He is handing over the reins to Kamala while they jointly embrace the radical left.Slow Joe and phony Kamala, perfect together, wrong for America.
骂越凶越在乎，不少美国媒体接获白宫内幕，川普最畏惧的拜登副手人选正是贺锦丽，害怕他充满能量的竞选风格替相对沉闷的拜登注入选战活水，尤其担忧贺锦丽成为拜登的非亚裔吸票机。如今川普故技重施，曾套用在前总统奥巴马身上的出生地争议拿来质疑贺锦丽的参选资格。
Can you definitively say whether or not Kamala Harris is meets the legal requirements to run as vice president?
So I just heard that. I heard it today that she doesn't meet the requirements. And by the way, the lawyer that wrote that piece is a very highly qualified, very talented lawyer.I have no idea if that's right. I would have assumed the Democrats would have checked that out before she gets chosen to run for vice president.
川普在白宫记者会上抛出质疑，声称立论来自《新闻周刊》12号刊出美国法学教授伊斯特曼的投书文章，内容以隐晦文字传达出母亲出身印度，父亲来自牙买加。身为有色人种及移民之子的贺锦丽非天然美国公民，不具参选副总统资格。川普对文章作者学经历的赞誉显然替该论点火上浇油，当场遭媒体不留情面发言挑战。
Do you have an issue with a strong woman of color being in this presidential race?
None whatsoever.
You don't see her as a threat?
As you know, none whatsoever.
贺锦丽1964年出生于加州奥克兰，在属地主义的美国是毫无争议的公民，可竞选公职。双亲纵使均为外来移民，也无碍这项事实。姑且不论川普是否有意让奥巴马案重演，便有分析直指，川普试图把拜贺佩描绘成激进左派同路人的做法，或许能催出既有保守派选民对他的忠诚，但他领导抗议无方，导致总统大选选情始终不振的当下，想翻转选前民调，眼前依旧路遥。
This is the map that made Donald Trump president. 2016, he got 306 electoral votes. Hillary Clinton got 232. Remember, Trump flipped Pennsylvania, Michigan, Wisconsin. None of those states had gone red since the 1980s. He flipped each one of them by a narrow margin. He won a bunch of big swing states. It was enough to get to 306. The question has been, 3.5 years later, as we head into the 2020 election, what's going to change? We think he's only got 125 in the bag right now. We think Biden is sitting there at 334. So what you're seeing here clearly is big gains for the Democrats.
当年川普靠大打美中贸易牌，让归于民主党麾下20多年的三大关键摇摆州宾州、密西根州、威斯康星州由蓝翻红，成功送自己进入白宫。三年半后，新冠病毒无预警突袭全美，旧王牌难发挥全效之下，川普还连带赔上原本十拿九稳的共和党票仓，如他视为第二家乡的佛州几乎确定变节，再加上德州在内共4州开始摇摆，都让川普距离白宫宝座越来越远。
Where are the Democratic gains on this map from 2016? Six states: Pennsylvania, Michigan, Wisconsin. We talked about those. All the polling in those states has been very encouraging for the Democrats. Plus, Arizona, Florida. That's a big one. 29 electoral votes, and North Carolina. Those six states.We think right now are moving towards the Biden column at this point. In those six states, you add them there to what Hillary Clinton had, 334. That's what Biden's sitting at right now, because none of the Hillary Clinton states, none of the states that were Hillary Clinton in 16 have switched and gone to Trump. Not at this point. So there's that. And then, so Trump has lost those six states. Also, Texas, Georgia, Ohio, Iowa, all states that went for Trump by big margins in 16.Toss-up states right now. They haven't moved to the Democratic side, but they have taken steps away from Donald Trump in all those states. That brings that number down there for Trump.
美国知名民调机构 538 在拜贺佩出炉后首次做出大选预测，认为拜登胜率 71%， 川普仅 29%， 理由是拜登在摇摆州依旧势如破竹，纵使近期领先幅度缩小，但有了2016年的教训，美国的民意测验还值得相信吗？ 538 坚持预测有方，点出当年希拉蕊川普之争，两位候选人民调差距小，且全在正常误差范围之内，直至2020年不同，无论全国民调或各州民调，拜登领先幅度均已超越希拉蕊，胜过川普的峰值，白宫将换新主人。